Harlem, northern fringe of New York's Manhattan, is accustomed to strange sensations. But a new kind of sensation to rhythmic, racy Harlem is a religious phenomenon called Father Divine, whose presence pervades all Harlem. All manner of businesses pop up throughout the district, all offering life's necessities at incredibly cheap prices, all stressing the passwords, peace and thank you, Father. To his eager followers, Father Divine is God on earth, and his headquarters shrill with the worship of his flock. No collections are taken, yet the Father's income is as large as it is mysterious. To what he calls Kingdom of Heaven number one, the mystery goes daily in his gleaming limousine. From all over the country, followers pour in by car and by special divine-owned buses to pay homage to his name. They receive his blessing from a loudspeaker connected with his inner sanctum.
Peace, everyone.
Thank you, Lord.
Sumptuous is the food, but no fork is raised to the entrance of the little spellbinder these folk choose to call God.
For those of you that are daily attendants, you realize this is not something out of the ordinary. This is a daily occurrence. A matter of course, expressing the practical force of psychology, of the spirit and the unfoldment of pornography, that men might understand the abundance of the fullness, is a living reality if they can and will concentrate on it.
When each cup of coffee has been blessed by the personal touch of Father Divine, who stands less than 5 feet high, he dines with his followers, to whom he gives evangelical names like Hot Sunshine, Bright Star, Tree of Life. Each day and night at public confessional, he hears the adoration of his flock.
I know Father Divine's voice!
Aware that 1936 is an election year, when many good men are coming to the aid of their country, aware that the season is open for national political conventions and for speeches resounding with hope and promises, Father Divine is moved to lead his followers into the political whirligig.
Name, please.
Heavenly Bouquet.
Name, please. Pete Determination. Name, please. Gracious Larry.
Their heavenly names legalized by the state Supreme Court, thousands of Divine followers are registered as voters. Then to his secretariat, Father Divine dictates his inspired platform. The frenzied crowd is welcomed by Paul Christian, Divine Disciple number one, who, should he be elected president, would enable Father Divine to become Gabriel over the White House.
Peace, everybody. Hoover could not straighten out this country. President Roosevelt has failed to straighten out this country. But God Almighty, Father Divine, will straighten out.
For all of humanity, I am broadcasting. from which we have drafted for consideration. Of the United States of America to cooperate if they will to, that they might enjoy the limitless blessings that I have put through. If they do not, I will punish you without them.
Wonderful.